In this series, I'm gonna show you how did I turn this game into this. Hey guys, I'm back with some fresh game dev content. It's been a while and I'm still busy as fuck, but you deserve a new video. So, in the next couple of videos, you'll get some insights about the development process of my new pixelart Pygame Space Shooter field trip. Bear with me, cause we have a lot to cover, including different spaceships, bullet hell, a variety of space hazards, loads of upgrades, cool power-ups, organic video and sound effects, cool pixel art, and of course, a bunch of amazing music tracks that I linked in the description. In this first part, I'll cover the basics of the game, the core mechanics, and the default ship. Before that, let's see a glimpse of the original field trip. This was my first space shooter minigame, and it's trash. I mean, the concept is really cool, but I could do so much better, and you'll see that very soon. So basically, this is a side-scroller asteroid shooter game, where the density of asteroids increase over time. As the time passes, you unlock new levels for your gun to put up a fight. The minigame is only a minute long, so don't expect too much. But I saw a lot of potential in the concept, so I dedicated a whole project for this minigame, and that was the birth of the standalone field trip. To say something Pygame related, some changes include separating the project into like 20 different modules, and utilizing the built-in sprite and group classes. So let's see the steps. After the usual setup, the first thing I implemented was the ship class with its controls. Although steel sprites are not so fun, so I included some basic animation. Then I prepared a really simple asteroid spawner at the right side of the screen. You can notice the size variation, but it's the same sprite scaled to different sizes. This is not good. What I always try to achieve is resolution, palette and style consistency. So you'll see that I changed these asteroids in a later version. One big change you may have also noticed is that the asteroids now rotate. Finally, one step closer to realism, as close as 2D side-scroller games can be.
Bruh.
Next, I added bullet spawning when you press space. You can even hold it, the cooldown makes sure you don't spread it like a madman. Although there's a problem here, if we play this part slowly. For now, it seems that all sprites are displayed in a random order on top of each other. The key to solve this problem is 1. Divide all different sprite objects into different layers. We could name this Z coordinate, but I stick to order. So later, when I refactored my game, I gave 0 to bullets, 1 to ship, and 2 to asteroids. And 2. Have a group that handles the drawing of all of the sprites, but sorted by this order attribute. Cool, huh? Okay, let's get back to the track. The next feature was the bullet asteroid collision. You can see the cool animation I play when an asteroid is destroyed. The simplest way is to use the rectangles around these objects to check colliding parts, but I don't recommend this. In the original field trip, I fell for this trap and there were moments where I seemingly collided with nothing, and it was very frustrating. To resolve this issue, we just need to create a mask for each sprite and check collisions with them. This way we avoid unpleasant situations. For the next feature, I implemented the player asteroid collision. To make it even better and cool looking, I added a blinking effect for the player sprite when it gets hit. For this effect, I used the built-in sine function and the time from Pygame. The result is a number between -1 and 1, and I can use this to show the white surface or not. Then I added the same effect for the asteroids as well. Now, to give meaning to this game, I added health for the player, and at the same time I created an overlay where I put as many health indicators as many health I have left. When the health reaches zero, the game crashes. Cool. Just kidding. Before that part, let's use the background image from the previous game. As I already showed it in a recent video, I used the infinite background technique for the side-scroller illusion. I also reused the sound effects from the original game. All the sounds you hear are organic and made by myself. Now, to give more challenge for the player, I started splitting the bigger asteroids into smaller ones. There are three sizes. Giant asteroids split into medium ones, and they split into small ones. As a next step, I wanted to reuse the concept of getting an upgrade when reaching a specific point in the game. To show the progress, I added a bar to the overlay object positioned to the top of the screen. I also displayed this transparent surface as the part of the UI. Another core feature I included was the overheat. Whenever you shoot a bullet, the overheat of the gun gets increased. If it reaches the maximum, you can shoot until it cools down. And as I said, I want to stick to the palette, so I use proper colors here. Now to favor the player, it's time to make the upgrades. Whenever the progress bar gets filled, the upgrade selection is triggered. The idea is to choose from a predefined list of upgrades. Each time the game rolls three upgrades, you can browse. The very first version of these upgrades was basically brown rectangles with some text on them. I know, it looks ugly, but not for long. I was thinking that these could be cards. So I drew some cards. The currently selected one has a different outline, and every acquired upgrade is shown on the overlay at the bottom of the screen. To make these cards more appealing, I drew some cute design for all of them. And now it was time for some particles. Whenever we hit an asteroid with a bullet, a small circle will be displayed with increasing radius at the point of impact. The next cool thing I added was screen shake. Basically, when we collide with an asteroid, the game screen gets random offsets on both axes. And you know what should shake the screen more? The shockwave of these cool missile explosions. I mean, it's a start. It has a cool acceleration and a deadly shockwave, but wait until you see the final version. Then, to make the game even more fun, I designed and added power-ups. Okay, this might be a little too much. Initially, I designed three of them: health refill, extra missile, and temporary shield. Yeah, nothing fancy here. The health refill, well, refills one health. The extra missile, gives you an extra missile. And the shield, lasting a couple of seconds, makes you invulnerable. To make these floating power-ups more fun, I added sine into their movement. So they go up and down. And even better, they leave particles behind, resulting in this cool effect. And while we speak about particles, the missiles now also emit a couple of circles while boosting into the asteroids. Now, the game looks pretty fun. What core mechanics do we miss? Well, of course, these core mechanics. Bruh, this video is getting long. Stay with me. Focus. I guess I'll leave the screen part and the other features for the next video. Let us have one last gameplay rolling in this state of the game. Yeah, thanks a lot for joining, guys. This is just the beginning. I feel the old buzz again when making games was pure joy. So make sure you stay with me along this journey. Leave a like if you enjoyed and subscribe to see the next part. Stay safe and take care.